So here with John Elder Robison in Montreal, Quebec, Canada, International Society for Autism Research annual meeting. And John, I wanted to tell you that I am scratching an item off my bucket list. This August 2019, I'm dragging my wife to a KISS concert, and this supposedly is the end of the line tour, the final tour for these guys who are 70 years old. You know, I don't know how many hip transplants they've had or whatnot, but apparently there's going to be lots of pyrotechnics and awesome music. I am a KISS fan musically, but I understand you go back in terms of technology and sound and help develop some of the music technology that they put into use. Can you tell us about that?
In the 1970s, I worked first for local bands, and then I worked for bigger and bigger bands. I started working for sound companies who leased sound equipment to rock and roll tours. I was hired by Britannia Row, who was the sound company formed by Pink Floyd, to lease out their equipment when the Floyd wasn't on tour. Yeah. So actually that was what first brought me to Montreal. As an adult, I had my 21st birthday riding a ferry to Corner Brook, Newfoundland.
Wow.
The First Glance tour with April Wine. Yeah. They're a big band in Canada, and we came back up here with Gino Vannelli, with Rush, Dan Hill, and Phoebe Snow. Wow. We had a bunch of Canadian acts. In the United States, the thing I'm best known for is we put together a monitor system for KISS for one of their tours of the 70s, and I got talking to Ace Frehley, the lead guitar player, and he asked if I could make his guitar blow fire. And I said, well, yeah, sure, you know. And so we hollowed out a Les Paul guitar. We put a stainless steel box in it. We insulated it. We put in smoke bombs and high-powered lights. And the thing burned so hot that it would pop the strings right off the guitar.
Oh, my
God. It would cover the stage in smoke. And we went on and we made a whole bunch of special effects guitars, all the ones you saw KISS play, and like you see them now in the videos from the 70s.
Wow,
that light up and shoot rockets and explode and stuff. And so that was one of the better known things I did in music. And you know.